everyone, and welcome to your December 2018 newsletter. And I am so excited to be able to deliver this to you today, December 1st. I'm going to be pulling from the Frequency Tarot, the Oracle of the Angels, and the Divine Guidance Deck by Cheryl Lee Harnish. Now, before I get into the cards, let's talk a little bit about the energy of the last 4 years. So, the energy of the last 4 years, how I have been shown what it has been doing for us is it's the birthing process. It really is. We are going through this birthing process to birth forth our light. You know, December really is that culmination of the birthing before we enter into the new year. And this new year, from the astrology that I've seen, from the Leo King astrology, from many other astrologers, 2019 is the year to step into your spiritual destiny, to birth forth the truth of who you are. You are not a time-space creature. You are infinite and vast beyond measure. You are the light of the sun, forever going out from the sun and creating beautiful beams of light, light creations. That is the truth of who you are. You are divine. And this year, these last 4 years, have been helping us to release beliefs, both emotionally, physically, spiritually, mentally, beliefs that don't support that. And that's what this is all about. We are in the quickening stage right now. You know, all of us have kind of been turned upside down. And we're ready to be birthed. We're ready to take a new breath in 2019. Now, we still have work to do. We still have some beliefs we need to look at and say, you know what? Do I want to keep this for 2019 or not? And the way that we do this is through positive denial. Okay, and I know you're probably thinking to yourself, denial? What? But positive denial. So if you are in a state of lack, if you're seeing lack in your bank account, if you're seeing, you know, that you're negative $5 or even $1,000, you look at it. You don't just sweep it underneath the rug and say it doesn't exist. And, you know, oh, no, sunshine, rainbows, lollipops, got to paint it pink. No, you look at your darkness to realize that it is not real and it has no power. And you do that with positive denial and you look at it. So let's say it's lack. And you say, God did not create lack. Now, of course, you don't have to use the word God. That's just what I ascribe to my higher power. So God did not create lack. Therefore, it is not real. I ask to see the truth instead of my dream of lack. The truth is, I am the holy, abundant child of God. I am whole, pure, perfect, protected, and provided for in all ways. It is God's will that I be happy. And then you know what you do? You go do what is in front of you to do. Be that, hey, you looked at the bill. You don't have the money. Dear God, I give this bill to you. I don't know what to do. I don't know how to do it. But I'm willing to see it differently. I'm willing to have your vision instead of my own. And, you know, be that something differently. It could be walking the dog. It could be going for a walk yourself. It could be playing video games with your children. It could be reading a book. It could be, you know, anything. But you have to release it. So you look at it, you release it. And then you can do that for 3 days. I'm not saying you do it forever, but do it for 3 days. Anytime you see lack, anytime you hear someone speaking lack, say it in your mind. Say it then, say it, say it. Say it. You have to apply as much as possible. Now, why 3 days? Because if you did it any longer, you would just be like, oh my gosh, this is too much. So 3 days is a perfect time to do that. And I actually learned that. It's a culmination teaching. I learned it from Marianne Williamson, as well as from Robin Duncan. And, you know, if you guys are interested in Robin Duncan's teachings, I'm going to put her her free website. All you have to do is put in your email and you will be able to get all of her 20 years of free content. And it's not just like, oh, here's a little this. No, it's full on amazingness. I love Robin. I think she is fabulous. She has helped me so much on my journey. So I'm going to put that in the description below. And then you know, speaking about birthing light, if you want some help with that, if you're like, well, I just don't know, I don't know how to step into it, I don't even know what my spiritual destiny looks like, well, then let me invite you to myself and Tammy Wernstrom's, of Spiritual Intuitive Tammy's, live multimedia event that we are holding January the 12th from 12 p.m. until 3 p.m. It's a one-day, three-hour intensive workshop on stepping into your spiritual destiny. And the reason I say it is live multimedia is because even if you don't live in the state of Indiana and you're like, oh man, I really wish I could go to that. Well, now there's no excuse because you can get on the free app called Zoom. You can download it to your phone, to your tablet, to your computer, and you do not have to be on the camera. You can just call in. That's also another option. So I love about Zoom to join us for this one-day, three-hour intensive workshop. So I'm going to put the description, or I'm going to put the website in the description below so you can check out the full specs on what we are offering for this. I mean, it's just absolutely phenomenal. I'm so excited and both honored to be able to assist people in this way. It's just going to be an amazing time. So with that all said, the last thing I want to say is I was contacted by a woman. And she is on the brink of losing her home. She needs to raise $1,800. And if you feel like you would like to donate, I'm going to go ahead and also put that link in the description below. All right. So thank you so much. And now let's go ahead and let's move on to the reading. All right. So first, we are here with the Frequency Tarot. So let's see. So we ask for guidance and protection. Okay, so we have our first card. So let's see. For December. Ah, beautiful. All right, so here we go. Our first card, Open to Life. Open to Life. So this card is really asking us to open up to the possibility of a brand new life. That's what this card to me is saying. Now, I'm sure the book has another description, but I'm just going to give you my intuitive insight right here, right now. And opening to life means it's time to open up to new avenues and being willing to see things differently, you know, from a new perspective, opening up to life, opening up to new adventures, new way of seeing things, new way of being, a new way of being, stepping more into love and out of fear. You know, that's what we're really being called to do in this month of December. And so we'll go over to the book and we'll see what she says about number 43. And I turned almost right to the page. So fabulous. I love when that happens. So it says, if you have drawn this card upright, your desire is to live your life or some aspect of your life on earth more fully. You may feel like there is no sense of direction. Your life may currently feel tenuous and pointless, or some aspect of your life may feel bad enough that you are drowning out the rest of the good. Stop living your life according to a bigger plan. Think only about the now. The time has come to care more about feeling good here and now instead of the bigger picture. And I actually really like that. It is about here and now. Oftentimes, when we are trying to figure out our destiny, trying to figure out our spiritual purpose, we're looking at this big grand picture, and especially we're looking at other people and saying, oh man, I want to do that and I want to do that. Well, the divine knows what's best for you. And that's actually one of the things we're going to be talking about, how to practically apply your spiritual purpose, okay, or your spiritual destiny in a practical way in life. And so we got to open up to life. We have to be open to be willing to see that our life can be used in a multitude of different ways, not just the way we think it should be. All right. And that's another thing we're talking in our retreat. We're talking about opening up to the divine plan, letting go of your plan and opening up to the divine plan. So now we're going to go over to the Oracle of the Angels, and we're going to see what beautiful affirmation we have for the month of December. Okay. Oh, yes. Okay. So application. I love this. You know, we've all been to the same seminars. We've all been to the same talks. We've heard the same CDs. We've heard the same tapes. Now is the time to apply everything that we have learned spiritually to help us to stay in that gratitude, to help us stay in joy and in love. We have to apply, apply, apply. You could read The Course in Miracles. You could read it. You could read it for 25 years. You could read it for 50 years. But if you don't apply the principles, it's just words. Empty words that sound really pretty. Don't get me wrong. Words are gorgeous. But they're just words until you apply it. So opening up to life means we have to apply what we have learned so that we can better open up to what life has to offer. Now we're going to go to the Divine Guidance deck, okay? The Divine Guidance deck. And this is actually fractal art. So we're going to see what other message comes through. Oh, okay, I don't even know what the card is, but I absolutely love it. Look at that, number 7. Oh, just beautiful, right? That beautiful heart. So let's see what the card's name is, and then I'll kind of give you my intuitive sense on it. Heart mind. Okay. So this is really what the Course in Miracles really teaches about as well, is taking the journey that has no distance from your head to your heart. You know, and that's what application is as well. It's about knowing a concept, but then experiencing that concept in form. Okay, experiencing the content in form. And that's really what this is about. And it says, learning to operate from the heart is the single most important thing that we can do. It is now time to activate your heart to its full potential. Spirit is asking you to make time to sit within the energy of your heart, learning to breathe through your heart while you meditate by focusing on your breath in your heart, feeling the loving energy inhale and exhale. Through this daily exercise, you'll become one with the heart mind, operating fully from a place of love. Absolutely beautiful. So let's kind of look at the overall picture here that the cards have painted for us. These three cards. So first we have number 43, opening up to life, being willing to see life differently, being willing to take a chance, being willing to follow your guidance. And how do we do that? Application, application, application. Like I said, if you are watching this, you have probably already read a lot of the spiritual books, or you've heard my spiritual talks, or you've heard other people's spiritual talks. It's time to apply those lessons. That's what's being asked of us, so that we can move into the truth of who we are, which is love. That is who we are. We are love. That is what we are. We are created in the image and likeness of our Creator, which means, it doesn't mean God looks like us. It simply means that love made us loving. Kindness made us kind. Perfection made us perfect. Okay? And the only thing that stops us from really recognizing that is this belief that we're just this small little time-space creature. We're just this body. We're made of nothing more than dust and sand from stars, and that's it. But we're not. This body, this personality is not the truth of who you are. The truth of who you are is love. This is the truth. There is no higher truth in the land than that. So we have to open up to that. We have to really apply ourselves, because you know what? The Course in Miracles says that the course isn't hard, but you have a lot of resistance because the thinking of this world is 365 degrees away from the thinking of love. And so this whole 4-year process has been teaching us how to think more and more with love, you know, how to give out of love, how to speak not only to ourselves, but others with love. And how to do that on a consistent basis, and we just have to apply. So thank you so much for joining me. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much for joining myself and Tammy for our live multimedia extravaganza that we're going to be having. And if you're interested in how to apply the spiritual principles of A Course in Miracles to really step into love, to step into your wholeness, the truth of who you are, to gain a life of happiness, ease, grace, and flow, then I'll put my website as well in the description below. And I send you all my love.